All right, hey, what's up everyone? Today we are doing a vinyl wrap removal on the front, or the hood rather, of this Mini Cooper. So I'm gonna walk you through the process on how we do it, how we're doing it, and the tools using. So I think it's not a, I'll show you in a second, and I got my Mini-Me helping me. So it's not a real warm day, which I was hoping for to kind of loosen the adhesive on this. Hey Ray. That's gonna be super loud. So I think what I'm gonna do first is use a heat gun in small sections to loosen it up, and then I got a few tools. This is the normal eraser wheel on a drill, but since it's such a big area, I got this thing as well. So this is gonna be a little bit more aggressive. This is also an eraser wheel, just a little bit more of an aggressive one that I'm gonna attach to the drill. Comes with this drill attachment as well. So I'm gonna try that. Then I have the 3M adhesive remover. So we'll see how it goes. I'll walk you through the process and show you everything as we go. Here we go. Here's my Mini-Me.
Hi.
What are we doing today?
We are doing this lady's car. I have no idea what. What is this?
Okay, a Mini Cooper.
Okay.
All right, so just an update here. As you can see, I did this side right here with this. The bummer is it's freaking really loud and it makes a ginormous mess. Ginormous mess. So what I decided to do was right here where it's not real bad, because I'm like, I'm gonna run out of eraser wheel and it's just so freaking loud. So what I decided I'm gonna do, especially there's more intricate parts like right around here and it makes a mess. But it's working, it's just making a huge mess. So what I decided to do is kind of regroup, and I've done vinyl sticker removal plenty of times and emblem removal with the eraser wheel, but never quite a project this big. So what I'm gonna, I decided to do, because that makes a mess and takes forever. So what I'm gonna do is go around the car as much as possible and just pull it off, utilize the heat gun, heating it, pulling it, heating it, pulling it, to get the bulk of the stuff done. And then come back with the eraser wheel. So that's it. Here we go. Right, so I just finished up the wrap removal, and really what I am at another location getting ready to do another car, but what I really learned on that wrap removal and kind of the tip of this of a how-to is, I went at it the traditional route of how I would normally do it with the eraser wheel, and kind of what the reason why I did that first was not because it was the more aggressive way, it was because I could see the cracking and the oxidation in the wrap. So I thought that was going to be the quickest way to do it, and I really quickly learned, because I did a little test spot, that was not the best way to do it. And in fact, the way that I thought was going to be longer and more tedious was actually the faster way, and that was heating it up. And what I was doing is actually heating it up before the part that I wanted to pull up, and then kind of balling up where I was pulling up as I was heating it over here, and then it was pulling up. Even the spots that were cracking were pulling up really, really easy. So I was happy for that. Ended up going very smoothly. Hit it with the adhesive remover after, and then I made such a mess with the eraser wheel that I actually decided to wash the car for the client as a way to over deliver, but really just to kind of clean up my mess. So if you're looking to do wrap removal, that's what I would suggest. It takes a little bit of time, takes a little bit of patience, but what you're going to want to use is a heat gun, adhesive remover, and just time. Just time. If you can, let that car sit out in the sun. As you can see, the sun's out now, but it wasn't. So I didn't have that going for me. But really what I would do is just that. So heat gun, little bit of time, and just little by little, keep going for it. Heating up where you want to pull off is really the big takeaway in the how-to. Heating up before you remove it, and really heating that area that you want to go, and then boom, it pops up right away. So that is how you remove a wrap, whether it's a Mini Cooper or a full body wrap. Hopefully it's not oxidized, and that's kind of the takeaway as well, is get it before it's real bad. So whether you hire a professional like myself or you're doing this at home, try to get it pre-cracking, pre-discoloration, and that's really gonna save you a ton of time. Hope you guys enjoyed that video. Subscribe for more. Catch you on the next one.